Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 18th August, Sunday, on the front page you have India-Bhutan Inc. 10 MOUs, Memorandum of Understanding. So these are MOUs which vow to strengthen ties. So here you can see Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his Bhutanese counterpart held talks. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi is on a visit to Bhutan. So various steps were discussed to further expand the bilateral partnership. So 10 MOUs have been signed, you can see. So here you can see the areas in which the MOUs have been signed are space research, aviation, information technology, power and education. So even the inauguration of Mangdechu hydroelectric power plant took place, and stamps to commemorate 5 decades of India-Bhutan hydropower cooperation were launched. So stamps to commemorate that were also launched. You can see Mr. Modi also launched the RuPay card in Bhutan by making a purchase of Simtokha Zong, which was built in 1629 by a person there, which functions as a monastic and administrative center. The details are given here regarding how digital payments are being encouraged. The RuPay payment system of India has been encouraged to be used in Bhutan too. Then this is restrictions relaxed in a third of Kashmir Valley. So people are cooperating with forces, only few indulging in violence is what German Kashmir DGP has said. So restrictions are being relaxed in Kashmir Valley. In one third of Kashmir Valley, restrictions are being relaxed. Then this is Trump asks Imran Khan to resolve Kashmir issue bilaterally. So this was a phone call between the two leaders. So this was made before UN Security Council held closed consultations, closed door consultations. On page 8, you have Andhra Pradesh invites reverse tenders for Polavaram project. So government is starting to online bid tomorrow. So it has called for a reverse bidding as such now, reverse tenders. So this is the detail. Polavaram project has been significantly in news. So how the tendering process is moving ahead is detailed out here. So reverse tender basically means that tenders had been issued and the lowest bidder has been selected. Now a reverse tender means anybody who wants to bid lower than that. So again, tenders will be can be submitted as such. On page 9, you have panel to review Chardham Highway. So Supreme Court has modified NGT order, National Green Tribunal order, and has set an independent committee headed by environmentalists, which will look into the center's ambitious 900-kilometer plan, which is a 12,000 crore ambitious Chardham project to improve road network connecting pilgrimage spots in Uttarakhand. So it should also have minimal ecological damage is a point raised. So NGT order has been modified by Supreme Court on this. Then this is again regarding traders pension plan. It has not been launched yet. So it's likely to be launched from August 19 is what is being stated. So we have discussed this quite often, Pradhan Mantri Laghu Vyapari Mandhan scheme for small traders, pension scheme for small traders. On page 10, you have the Thimphu Space Link has a Bengaluru stamp. So there is a Bengaluru stamp on the satellite Earth station that Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated in Bhutan's capital Thimphu. So the satellite Earth station has been built and manned by Alpha Design Technologies of Bengaluru. So this Earth station will help drive various social services of the South Asian satellite, that is GSAT-9, which has been built and set up by Alpha Design Technologies. And on international page, you have this coverage on revolution in Sudan. The ruling military council of Sudan has signed a power sharing deal with the civilian opposition. So this is going to bring in elections and eventually rule of civilians is what is expected. So this coverage on this. The Sudanese military civilian signed transition deal. Then on business page you have consumer durable services segments drag loan growth. So housing loans are growing at 18.9% year on year, marking an exception. Otherwise, consumer durable services segment loan growth has been dragging. They have contracted significantly. Then on Sundays, you have this FAQ coverage where important issues are covered in detail. So generally, there are these three important issues. So today, the first issue is, why is the auto industry facing trouble? So auto sector has been in news. It is experiencing prolonged negative growth. So this article covers what are the reasons for the same and why are jobs being lost and how can the government help? So this is very important. And this is a crisis of legitimacy. So this is regarding Sikkim, the situation in Sikkim. The Supreme Court is hearing a writ petition challenging appointment of Chief Minister of Sikkim. So that is the issue covered here. And this is, what is the UN stand on Kashmir? So UN Security Council, we saw in news, has held closed door meeting on Kashmir. So the UN Security Council members are urging India and Pakistan to resolve the issue. But what are they asking the countries to do? What should India and Pakistan do to resolve the issue? What is UN security, UN stand on the matter is covered here. Then on Sundays, you also have science and technology coverage. So here, the first coverage is brain-computer interface enhanced by active rehabilitation of stroke patients. So trained neural network was used to develop a system that could effectively benefit stroke patients. So this is a research undertaken by IIT Palakkad researchers. And this is why the new TB drug shows promise. So this is pritomanid, which is only the third anti-TB drug approved for use by the FDA in more than 40 years. So this drug shows promise. What is the detail of this drug is given here. And on the last page you have, planet 10 times Earth's mass may have smacked Jupiter long ago. So collision may have had lasting effect on the Jovian core, is what this study has shown, that a planet smacked Jupiter. So these are the important headlines. Thank you.